Welcome to this Made for Success audio program. The audio you are listening to is designed to turn your potential into performance, succeed in every area of your life, and achieve your dreams. Now sit back and relax as our featured speaker begins.
Finding Your Moxie, Myths and Lies Successful Women Kick to the Curb. Written and narrated by Debra Fox. Preface. Over my lifetime, I have been called a bitch with balls on more than one occasion. As far as I can remember, the comment was usually from men. As crass as that may sound to many, coming from men, I soon figured out it was usually meant to be a compliment. I credit that attitude with my being able to achieve what I have in my life in spite of obstacles, and that attitude is the foundation of this book. Although I didn't feel that would be a good title for the book, primarily because women may view that as a negative thing, I wanted to express the same strength and attitude. I chose the word Moxie for the title because I truly felt it represented me, the key to my success, my story, and my message. Some people may remember Moxie as one of the original soft drinks sold in the late 1920s. Today, Moxie has taken on another meaning. Moxie, noun, American informal. Vigor, courage, know-how, spirit, aggressive energy, confidence, fearlessness, fortitude, determination, gumption, and just plain guts. I've spent my life being told, you're too fat. You're not big enough in your industry. You're not educated enough. You're not successful enough. You're not political enough. You don't ass-kiss enough. You're not nice enough, and on and on. I spent the early part of my life feeling like an outcast, defeated by the opinions of others, beat down, and ready to give up. Quite frankly, it was exhausting. If you have Moxie, you won't let any setback stop you from trying again, because you're a determined person who doesn't give up easily. Finding Your Moxie is a no-nonsense, matter-of-fact, straightforward, realistic look at your life and how to develop enough Moxie to overcome, plow through, stand up for, and achieve whatever it is you set as your goals in your life. Every day in my seminar rooms, classes, and speaking engagements, I look out at the faces of women who are beat down and fed up. Many of them have been led to believe that because of one thing or another, they simply won't be able to reach their goals, achieve success, or be happy. They spend the majority of their lives surrounded by well-meaning people, marketing firms, and advertising agencies who are committed to selling them a false bill of goods in the form of myths, lies, and half-truths. In order to be successful, you must have a college degree. In order to be successful, you must have the perfect smile. In order to be successful, you must make a lot of money. In order to be successful, you must look like a model. In order to be successful, you must. I think you get the picture. And like me, I find that many of them feel defeated and are either ready to give up or, worse yet, have already given up. So, they settle. They settle into a routine. They settle for a job instead of a career. They settle for a secondhand life. And they may even settle for a life partner who really isn't the best partner for them. As a result of my upbringing and a change in the world around me, I was suddenly surrounded by a world that was telling me I didn't have what it was going to take to be successful. Even in the late 1970s and early 1980s, the prejudices were still strong against women in the workplace. That isn't where it stopped. I grew up watching Cinderella and Snow White and falling into what later became known as the Cinderella Complex. Believing that my Prince Charming would find me and we would get married and live happily ever after. Unfortunately, like many, my first boyfriend in high school dumped me for one of my closest friends. I'm happy to say that they're still married today. At the time, however, I had just experienced my first in a long line of reality checks. After receiving countless letters and emails and having women approach me after seminars crying and telling me I changed their lives, I decided it was time to share my thoughts with the rest of the world. Have you ever found yourself faced with reality checks? Have you had people tell you that you can't be successful because? Have you given up, or are you ready to take the path less traveled and succeed? If you said you are ready to take the path less traveled, then let's explore some of the more common myths and half-truths that I grew up with and share what it takes to be confident and successful in spite of them. And now, a Moxie Minute. Bitchology. I stand up for myself and my beliefs. I stand up for those I love. I speak my mind, think my own thoughts. I won't compromise what's in my heart. I live my own life my way. I won't allow anyone to step on me. I refuse to tolerate injustice. It means I have the courage and strength to allow myself to be me. So try to stomp on me, douse my inner flame, or squash every ounce of beauty I hold within. You won't succeed. And if that makes me a bitch, so be it. I embrace the title, and I'm proud to be a bitch. Introduction. I have found over the years, and still believe today, that our society places huge expectations and/or limitations on women regarding what it takes to be successful. First, it was, you have to have an undergraduate degree. Then, a master's degree is the new bachelor's. We've now reached the point where you need a PhD if you want to be considered competitive in the workplace. The magazines aren't much help either. You need to be beautiful. Nope, now you need to be beautiful and thin. And don't forget that your teeth need to be perfect and white. You have to have just the right tan, and you need to be able to schmooze people. Oh, and don't forget, you can be or do anything you want. Not only are there huge expectations or limitations placed on women regarding career successes, I believe there is another set of expectations placed on women by other women. The difference between the two expectations creates a tightrope that women are expected to walk in order to keep everyone happy. On a daily basis, you can receive countless pieces of advice that every person under the sun is willing to give you. These myths, lies, and half-truths misrepresent what the true message is with well-meaning statements of what you should do instead. Trying to figure out how to make your way through this crazy maze of expectations, both the ones placed on you by others and the self-inflicted, unrealistic expectations we place on ourselves, is a source of frustration for many. But guess what? Being successful is not about keeping everyone else happy. It's about making sure, at the end of the day, that you are happy. It's taken me years and tons of trial and error to figure out exactly how to do that. I'm going to share some cold, hard truths about the cold, hard truths. What it takes to achieve true inner happiness while still being successful. Throughout my life, I have been blessed with so many wonderful and diverse experiences. But these experiences were only possible because of the choices I made starting at a very young age. While still in high school, I had the unbelievable opportunity to travel across the country performing with a semi-professional gospel group. Talk about learning how to get along with people in tight quarters. There were over 25 of us traveling on an old, repurposed Greyhound bus. We couldn't use the bathroom on the bus because the tuba was stored in the commode during our road trips. This is where I learned to sleep anywhere, including on the floor, lulled to sleep by the humming of the transmission below me. At age 20, I competed for and was honored to win Miss Rodeo Kansas. For those of you who are unfamiliar with this program, this pageant selects a state queen to represent the PRCA, the Professional Rodeo.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.